Hello guys, my name is Koushik and welcome back to the Chrome extension development tutorial where we are going to develop the XPath tool. XPath tool can be developed in two ways. One is using the Chrome dev tools. So whenever I go and click on inspect, I am able to see this dev tools, right? So here within this styles and event listener, here I can attach a new name and whatever the XPath I'm going to get in the runtime, I can move it to there, right? But I really don't want to do that because my intention is very simple. A person should right click and on the right click, they should get the XPath. No need to open the dev tools. So obviously we have to do it the other way, that is using the context menu. Now context menu is nothing but whenever we are going to do right click, we are able to get this back, forward, reload and some Chrome options, right? So in the context menu, we are going to bring our XPath integration here. So whenever a person going to right click, they should see a option here, somewhere here, says that get XPath. When the persons click on that, then a pop-up menu should come which will contain our XPath. Now let's see how to do that in using Chrome API. So first of all, this is our previously written code where whenever we are going to refresh a page, we will get this alert, right? So I'm going to command that. That is just to do the confirmations that our extension is loaded successfully. So I'm going to command that. Now we'll understand what is content script and what is background. So content script is like something which is going to lies in your browser in the UI level in the sense in the front end, that is within this page, okay? And background is something which is going to lies in different environment, which is like your background of your application. For example, if I go to this extension page, here we are able to get this ID and this everything, right? This is not going to affect our actual UI. It's in the background where it's sending us some message or information, I can say. So we have to deal with the background for sending any message and we have to receive that in our content script. Now content script can directly communicate with our existing DOM. Existing DOM in the sense the page DOM. So whatever the page we have right now in front of us, we can communicate with the DOM using content script. But whereas background script will be triggered based on some user action. For example, whenever I'm going to click on this right click, now this background is going to work. So it will send us some communication, I mean some information. Based on that information, I can pass it to my content script. We'll see that in detail, maybe in another video. As of now, let us understand the importance of background script. So if I go and check on the overview, here we can see that it needs a background, right? So background, as discussed, it is going to lies in our browser within the backend side, not in the front end. That means not in the UI side. Now I'm going to copy this and here I'm going to paste in my manifest.json. Now here within the background, we have two values. So one is persistent. Now let us understand what is persistent. Persistence means we have to give either true or false. That is, whenever we are going to give it as false, that means it will only use the browser resource upon any user request. For example, if I have a context menu, if I click on that, then only background is going to work. If I give the value as true, then it means that our background script is going to run forever. That means it is going to take our browser resource each and every time. That is bad way. I cannot say bad way, but that is not needed for us because we want our extension to be very responsiveness. So obviously I cannot use the browser resource all the time, but I want to use the browser resource once the user interactions or the user clicks, right? So here we have to make the persistent as false. Now second thing is script. Now if you have noticed, here we are passing the script name within array, right? That means it can accept so many script at a single time, but in our case we need only one script, that is going to be background script. Now here I can make a new file, so I'm going to name this as event page. event.js. Now, event page is also known as background page as well, but event page means whenever we are going to make this persistent as false, that is going to be event page. That means once the user start to use it, it is going to be trigger some events. So this is just a name, so I'm going to remove this, and instead of I'm going to call my file name, which is eventpage.js. That's pretty much cool. Now we are going to create our context menu, right? So before that, creating context menu, let's see the documentation. So here it says chrome.contextmenus, right? Of course, you can see that it's menus. That means we can have multiple menus in our extension. But as of now, I'm going to create only one. Maybe in further, if required, we will have multiple menus as well. So the first thing, in the manifest file, we have to add this permission. The manifest concept is very simple. This will decide like whatever the extension permissions we have to provide. So whenever you are going to use any API from Chrome APIs, then without permissions, it will not work. So obviously, each and every time, whatever you are going to use, you have to set the permission in the manifest. So I'm going to copy this and I'm going to paste in our permission in our manifest.json. So here I can add comma and the value, right? Fine. Now we have given the permission, but we have to actually create the context menu as well, right? So if I go to the documentation, and here you can see we can create, we can update, we can remove, and we can remove all. So first let us create one context menu. So I'm going to click on this create, and here it says that it needs integer or string as an argument, and also it needs to be this syntax, right? So no need to worry about the syntax and all. I'm going to explain you anyways. So let's jump into the code. So within our event page, I'm going to say chrome.contextmenus.create. So create is the function which is going to create our context menu. Now within the context menu, we have to pass an object data type where it needs some data like ID. Now ID is used to identify the context menu. So I'm going to give the name as maybe let X. After that, we are going to also specify title. Now title means whenever we are going to do the right click, we should see some text, right? So the text will come from this title tag. So here I'm going to say get XPath. After that, we also want to say what are the permissions we are going to give this context menu. For example, using context menu, we can do the click action, or let me show you that. So here we have the values, right? So using the context menu, we can click on the page or the frame, or we can have selection. Selection is nothing but you are selecting like this, right? Upon selection, what we wanted to do. So for that, we have to set the permissions. And then if you're going to interact with the link or editable or image or video, so based on that, we have to give the specific values. But in our case, we never know what element type it's going to be, right? So for that, obviously, we have to use this all as a permission. So I'm going to copy that, and here I'm going to say context, and within the context, I have to give the value as all. Now, if you see, we have multiple values, right? So obviously, I have to pass this within array. So I'm going to use the square bracket here, right? Now we have created our context menu. So let me go to my Chrome browser. And if I go to this extension page and let me refresh this. Now, if you see, when I do the right click here, I'm able to get this as get XPath, right? So this is very simple to create a context menu. But actual thing is, when we created a context menu, we should tell that what elements we are going to get, right? Probably we will see that in the next video. As of now, let's understand. Now I wanted to confirm that whether the context menu has been really working or not. So we are going to just give a alert as of now. So here I'm going to say context menu on click. Okay, so I'm going to call the event listener. So Chrome dot context menu And onClick is a function where we are going to add the event listeners, that is add listeners. In the add listeners, we are going to check if the context menu has been clicked or not, right? So in the listeners, we will get a callback function. Now, if you are not familiar with callback function, I can say like it's going to run in asynchronous, right? So whenever it's going to run, it will provide us that, okay, after the completion of this, we have to run this. That is what callback is actually. But maybe in further videos, we'll discuss about callback in detail. Now I'm going to use the ES6 arrow syntax. Let me show you that. So this is how I used to write my JavaScript code. So probably you can follow that. This is nothing but the same, like here I can say, instead of this arrow syntax, I can name it as function. And here I'm going to create this. Okay, so both the syntax are exactly same. Only difference is how you are going to write that. Now this is like your anonymous function, right? So function without any name is anonymous function. So here we are going to use the anonymous function. So instead of mentioning it as a function, I can use the arrow syntax. If you want to know about functions in JavaScript, probably you can check my JavaScript tutorial videos. So I'm going to comment this as of now. You can have it for your reference. So here I'm going to say, before that, we have to understand that this add listener from this onClick function is going to return as a callback as the information and also the tab ID. So if I show you the documentation, here we can see that we have events, which is onClick, right? So from the event section, we can see this onClicked. Now within this onClicked, we have this line, right? So chrome.contextmenus.onClicked, and it is going to have a add listener. Now in the add listener, we have to pass a callback. This callback holds information about the object, that is whatever we are going to do the click on, and also the tab ID. Now why tab ID is important means, for example, you are going to do the context click here and there, but your extension must know from where we are doing the click. So we have to pass the tab ID as well. Now do not worry about this tabs.tab or this info or everything. We will talk about in detail in upcoming videos. As of now, let's focus on how to create the context menu. So here we know that this guy is going to give us info and also with the tabs, right? So tab information. Here what I'm going to do is, once I click on this, I'm expecting an alert from my UI. So here I'm going to say alert, and here maybe we can pass the info, so we'll get that, okay, so whatever we are going to click on, we'll get some information about that, right? So let me go back to my browser, and if I go to this extension page, and here you have to do the refresh. Now if you have noticed, I'm doing this refresh often in our previous video as well, right? The reason is, whenever we load our extension within this browser, it is going to take that source code and it is going to keep it in its memory, in its environment. But when we do some changes, we have to do the refresh so that our latest code will get affected in our browser. We have to refresh this browser as well as this page, because this page also has its own memory where it doesn't going to take our code from our local disk. It is going to take from its own memory. So each and every time, once you update the extension, you have to reload the page as well. So now here I'm going to click on this and I'm going to say get XPath. As expected, we are able to get this object, right? But we want to know what is this object is of, right? So here what I'm going to use is object.keys, okay, which is nothing but which will give you the keys and values on your object data type, right? So here I'm going to say info. So I'll get all the keys from my object. Okay, so let's refresh our browser again. So I'm going to refresh our extension, and again I have to refresh this page as well. Now if I do right click and click on get XPath, here I can see that we are getting some informations, right? Like it's editable or frame ID or link URL or what is the media type and what is the menu item ID and what is the page URL and what is the source URL. Now do not worry about this. We might not use this everything, so do not worry about this. Just to make sure that our context click is working now, I have done that. So in the next video, we will see how to get the XPath or the ID from any element wherever we are going to do the right click and click on get XPath. So I hope you have enjoyed the video. In the next video, we will see more in detail. In our further videos, I'm going to tell each and everything about how Chrome extension works and how does we have to use the Chrome extension API. So if you like the video, please do share and like and consider giving a subs to the channel. Thanks for watching. My name is Koushik and see you in the next one very soon.